I've been messing with these little alcohol burning stoves, and this is one I've made out of a repurposed aluminum beverage container. And one of the problems with an alcohol stove is, of course, that you have to protect it from the wind, or the wind will blow it out. Let me go ahead and light this one up, and I'll turn the light off and I'll show you what's going on here. So here we go. Looks like the jets are almost primed on this one. Let's see if I can get them to... There we go. So now you can see the jets going on that thing. And normally, you know, you get your pot on the jets right there. But if a good gust of wind was to come along, it can blow your stove right out. Now granted, I had to use a pretty decent gust of wind there and start right back up. So you gotta have some kind of a windscreen to protect your flame on there. So I'm gonna show you tonight how to build a windscreen for an alcohol stove that'll cost you a dollar and is real easy to make at home. So here's what you're gonna need. I was wandering around Walmart looking for something that I could use, and I found these right here. It's Hefty's Easy Foil Casserole Pans, and they have a fairly thick foil on them, and you get a two-pack for $2. So obviously we're just going to be using one of those. I'll pull one out of here. It's a fairly decent thick aluminum. I mean, the ideal soft stuff for making windscreens is probably 30-gauge soft aluminum. But you know what? This will work, and for a dollar, if it lasts a few campouts, that's perfect, and then you just go make another one. The other things you'll need are maybe a small pair of pliers. A box knife is really the only required item. And then I happen to have just a hole punch laying around here for putting grommets into tarps and stuff. And so I use this for knocking holes in the bottom of the windscreen to give it some airflow. But you could use a screwdriver or whatever just to make some small holes. So really, it's just a very minimum of tools required. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing I do is I take my box knife and I cut right on this inner line here of the casserole pan. And I just want to make a nice... follow that contour so we end up with a nice round centerpiece cut out of there. Okay, that's step one. Now we're actually going to save this center portion, so go ahead and just set it off to the side. And step two will be to take your box knife and just pick a spot anywhere you want to, and we're going to make a straight cut right through the side of the casserole dish, like so. So now our casserole dish is separated. Okay, now depending on how much time you actually want to spend on this, what I've done is I usually curl this inner lip over, and I usually do it in two folds. So I fold it in half down, and then I'll fold it in half again on itself. And you kind of have to do a little bit at a time, because we're trying to keep that edge fairly straight. So we're going to roll it halfway, and then we'll go back and roll it the rest of the way over, giving it a nice edge that's not sharp at all and should provide a little bit of strength to the windscreen as a whole. Okay, there's the first fold, and then I'm going to go back and fold it pretty much right to the rim of the crinkly part. Okay, so now I got an edge that's at least not jagged sharp. So at this point, the basic windscreen structure is pretty much done, with the exception that we probably should put some holes in along the bottom just to give it a little bit of airflow to feed the stove. Just in case, you know, you don't want to starve your stove for oxygen. Like I said, you could do this with just a screwdriver and just jam some holes through it. No big deal. Just pick your spot, put some holes in, and you know, just kind of spread them out a little bit. It doesn't take a whole lot of air to run these things. Just put it in near the bottom. We got some holes made. Well, now your windscreen's basically done. We can go back to that middle piece that we cut out, and you can actually use this as an insulator to place your stove on. You could even run the edges up like this and make a small pan out of it if you wanted to use a priming pan to heat the outside of your stove faster. But you can usually just set that on the ground, set your stove on there, and then you'll take your windscreen and wrap it around. Let's see, let's get the pot. There we go. And I've seen a lot of stuff about people experimenting with different sizes of windscreens and how much room to leave. But you know, you can figure out what's going to work for you. And then just bend your aluminum foil windscreen to fit. I got one of these little bulldog paper clips here, which has turned out to work really well. Just clamp it down, and you could use a paper clip, or heck, you could line up a couple of the holes and put a stick through it to hold it. But there's your windscreen. Put your pot on there, and you're golden. Okay, I realized after the fact that we should probably do a little wind test in the garage. So I've got the windshield on. I'm just going to take some stuff I got laying around the shop and pretend I'm laying sticks or rocks around the edge, which you know you'd want to do to keep your windscreen from being blown away. The windscreen doesn't weigh very much, see? So you know, you just pile some sticks or rocks around it just to keep it from moving. In this case, we've got screwdrivers and some other stuff. And I'm going to use my trusty shop air hose, and I'll turn out the lights and we can watch the flame and see what happens. Not too bad. It's affecting it a little bit, but I mean, how often are you going to have wind like that ripping through your cooking area? It doesn't blow it out. It keeps it going. So, pretty cool. Looks like the little windscreen works. So as far as packing this thing up goes, what I've been doing is just unclip it and kind of just roll it as tight as I feel like it wants to go without wrecking it. And just kind of roll the thing up following its natural curvature, like so. And then grabbing that clip and kind of shoving it in there like that. And that holds it pretty good. And makes a nice reasonably tight package there. And then this piece, I've just been folding it into kind of a pie shaped deal there. I've got the digital weigh scale set to read in ounces. So first up would be the base plate. It comes in at 0.23 of an ounce. Then the heat shield brings that total weight to 1.26 ounces, including the clip. We back up. We put the stove on there. My stove is 1.25 ounces. It's a little bigger than the Bud Light ones. It's about a quarter inch diameter bigger than a Bud Light stove, which gives us, for everything, a grand total of 2.50 ounces, which, that's nothing. I mean, that's really light. I can definitely carry that in my pack, no problem. It's cold out here today. It's December. I gotta kinda watch that. And we're gonna just let it get primed up, and then we'll get the stove going. It's hard to see the flame on alcohol outside, so I can kind of hold the pot down there, and yeah, it's burning. Just kind of hovering the pot, and eventually it'll get that hot enough to get the jets going. Okay, the stove's primed. I could hear it, and I can see the flames on the side jets, so I'm going to go ahead and set the stove down. Now, I've heard a couple of people say you want to suck in the heat shield closer to your pot. I'm just going to leave it about like that. You could experiment and figure out, what size of pot you need and how close you want to get it. I heard one guy say a quarter inch off of the stove was a good measurement. But, I can feel the heat coming up out of there, so it's definitely going, and we'll let this boil up and have some hot chocolate. I'll put the lid on. There we go. Stove's looking good. Didn't get blown out by any wind or anything, and got a good rolling boil on 2 cups of water pretty darn fast. So we'll go ahead and pour that out, make some hot chocolate, and well, I see that windscreen works decent. Not bad for a dollar.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked what you saw, please take a moment and click the like or thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. Likes, subscriptions, and favoriting videos really makes a difference and encourages me to make more of these videos. Thanks.